I only have one memory. We were with my grandfather and it was in the basement of our house. And the only thing I remember is my grandfather putting earmuffs around us, and then a bomb exploded a few houses or streets down. I really can't remember. But that's the only, it's like a picture, like a clear picture memory of that. And then nothing else. We had to leave our home country of Iraq when we were 4 years old. And the catalyst for us leaving was the wars that were going on. Political unrest is still happening to this day in our country. So we came to the United States in 2014. I feel like we're pretty blessed that we have each other. I just think having a twin will always be my favorite thing in the world. Obviously, because we were born in Iraq, and it's not something that's like this giant priority to like write down who came out when exactly. People say, because she's a little bit more quiet, that she must be older, and I must be a little younger. And I'm okay with that if that's true, but we have no idea. I can't imagine going into life as a singleton. And then we also say the same things all the time.
Yeah, exactly.
We've both been interested in medicine for a very long time, I would say. We could incorporate the love that we have for biology, chemistry, physics, and then incorporate that into helping other people and helping families just like ourselves. And then that's kind of where the passion blossomed, and we pursued that throughout undergrad, and now we're here in medical school. The reason we chose EVMS is because we just wanted to go to a school that we could tell cared about their community and cared about their students a lot. We are very interested, and we are active in a lot of organizations on campus, especially Refugee Health. Refugee Health is a CEL here at EVMS, and the main focus of it is improving the quality of life and the health outcomes of the refugee populations. And we try to target that as holistically as possible.
So today we're at the museum, and we're here with the Refugee Health students, and we gave them a prompt, and that prompt relates to refugees in some way. And their task today is to go look at art and to see which one resonates with that prompt, and then be able to discuss that with the rest of us and talk about what the art means to them and their work in refugee health.
Refugee health is unique in that it treats the populations locally. We're really passionate about refugee health because we were refugees. We were able to understand all the struggles that they have, because when we came in, we also felt isolated, alone, we were scared. We missed, obviously, our family, our friends. Both of us got need-based scholarships from EVMS. It's going to limit the amount of loans that we would have to pay back. The money that we got from the scholarship is going to really help us focus our attention and our time on all of the extracurriculars that we're involved in. Trying to prepare for our board exams, or it would give us more time to actually spend working and being with our patients. It really puts things into perspective. Somebody is providing you this amount of money out of the kindness of their own heart. And I really, really hope one day I get to be able to do this to somebody, make them very, very happy, knowing what you know about how helpful and beneficial that was for you.